virtual church. Thanks so much for coming out and joining us today. You know, we love you guys. We pray for you guys. And I think about you through the week. So even if I haven't seen your smile in person in a little while, I want you to know that I'm carrying you in my heart. And of course, this comes to you today from my heart to your home. You know, we live in a very uncertain world. And maybe you would say, you know, what's going to happen if inflation keeps going up? What's that going to do to my family budget? Or what if I get sick? I might lose my job and not be able to work. Or what if I lose someone I love? And we all go through these storms in life, but I want you to know that you have an anchor in those storms, and his name is Jesus. Here's our band recorded live in worship with "You Are the Anchor." Happy Sunday. Well, I want you to know that you put a smile on God's face this morning. Thanks for coming out, for being a part of things, for watching this right now. You know, one of the ways you can tell that you're from Southwick is that every spring you can smell the manure out on the fields. I remember the first time I drove by a freshly fertilized cornfield in Southwick. I was like, whoa. I mean, like, well, what is that smell? It stinks out there. But if you drive by that same spot a couple of months later, the smell is gone and the crops are growing like crazy. that fertilizer, as bad as it stinks, is giving those plants everything they need to grow. Well, guess what? In the same way, we all go through some stuff in life that stinks. We don't know why it happened. We don't like that it happened. We feel like it wasn't fair. You know, like, why did I lose my main client? Or why did that relationship not stand the test of time? Or why did I come down with this sickness? And let's be honest, when you're going through something like that, it stinks. But you need to keep the right perspective about it. It's just fertilizer. It may stink right now. It may feel like you've had a pile of manure dumped on you. But that stuff that stinks is not working against you. It's working for you. It may smell bad for a while, but if you keep doing the right thing, you're going to come out into a new season of growth. You know, I'd like to be able to tell you that if you just believe in God and do your best, that you're going to sail through life without any difficulties whatsoever. But that's not reality. You're going to have some manure. There's some smelly stuff in your future. Some days are going to feel like kind of crappy. Instead of getting depressed over it and thinking, well, this stinks, I can't believe this happened to me, have this attitude. It's all just fertilizer. God is getting me prepared right now for something greater. You may feel as if you've already had enough stuff in your life, your share of stinky stuff in life, bad breaks, broken dreams, breakups. But look at it this way. If you've already gone through a lot in your life, well, you ought to feel encouraged, because with all that fertilizer, you're going to be entering into a really great period of growth, and you're really going to be someone special. Friend, if you're going through some of that stuff right now, let me just give you three things to think about, three things to keep in mind. First of all, give the fertilizer time to work. Give it time. There was a young woman who grew up in a very difficult environment. Her father died when she was just 6 years old, and her mother was very unhealthy. She was on dialysis. And when the other kids were outside playing with their friends, she was always home taking care of her mom, running the kidney machine. By the time she was 12, she was doing all the grocery shopping for the family. She was cooking all the meals for the family, and every day she was getting her brother dressed and ready for school. It seemed like she was at a disadvantage growing up. But just because something seems unfair doesn't mean that God doesn't have a great future for you if you give it some time. This young woman didn't complain or feel sorry for herself. Despite all the odds stacked against her, she worked real hard in high school, and she got a full scholarship to college. She went on and she got her master's and she got her doctorate. Today she is crushing it in the corporate world, and she's happily married with three kids. Now here's my question for you. Why do some people in that same type of situation struggle all through life? I mean, why do some people with exact same circumstances live their entire life defeated, always complaining about their problems, never making any progress, while others, like this young woman, overcome the odds and flourish? Well, the answer is, it's how we approach life. We all have stuff that stinks and unfair situations, things we don't like. And you can get bitter and you can be discouraged, or you can see it as fertilizer. You can see it as fertilizer and say, this difficulty is not going to defeat me, it's going to promote me. It's not going to hinder me, it's going to help me. So the next time, listen, the next time you see that person at work who just gets on your nerves, instead of getting upset, why don't you just take a look at them and smile and think to yourself, you are just fertilizer. You stink, but you're helping me grow. And look at them and think to yourself, you think you're pushing me down, but you're not. You're pushing me up, because I know a secret. It's all just fertilizer. It's going to cause me to bloom and blossom and flourish. And be sure of this. No experience is wasted. With God, nothing is ever wasted. Maybe because of a mistake you made, you feel washed up. You feel like you've blown your chance. Maybe Maybe you even brought the trouble on yourself. I mean, look, we all make some poor choices. We all make some bad decisions. We all find ways to get off track in life. But God doesn't waste anything. He knows how to get some good out of every situation. I mean, it may not be good, but he can cause it to work for good. For example, one day Jesus met this woman at a well. And the woman opened up and she told Jesus how she didn't have a husband. And Jesus smiled and he said gently to her, "Well, you're right when you tell me that, aren't you? Because the truth is, you've had five husbands, and the man you're living with right now, he's not your husband." She was amazed that this stranger could know everything about her. Sensing something amazing was about to happen, she said to Jesus, "Well, I know that one day the Messiah is going to come. Could it be?" Jesus looked deep into her eyes, and he said, "I'm the one that you've been waiting for, the Messiah." Here's what's amazing. The first person Jesus ever told that he was the Messiah was this woman. A woman who had a rough past, who had made a lot of mistakes in life, who had gone through a lot of stuff that stinks. Well, she went running back to town and she said, "Hey, everybody, I think I've met the Messiah. He knew everything about me." The whole town came running to meet Jesus. So think about this. God used her as the first evangelist to get the word out that he was the Messiah. Now, here's my point. Having been married five times, this woman was, well, how should we put this? Comfortable around men. If she had been shy and easily intimidated, she wouldn't have told so many people. So God used all those qualities that in the past had gotten her into trouble. Her boldness, her forwardness. And he turned all that around and he said, in effect, "I'm not going to waste that. I'm going to use that to advance the kingdom." It had worked against her. Now it's going to work for her. No experience is wasted. It's true in your life also. No experience is wasted. There's a story on the news about a 22-year-old gunman who walked into an elementary school with an assault rifle. He began shooting at the first responders. Fortunately, no one was hit and no one was hurt. After everyone scattered, he barricaded himself in a small room. Hiding behind the counter of that small room was the accountant, the school accountant, a middle-aged woman by the name of Ms. Tough. And boy, that was a perfect name for her, because Ms. Tough stood up, looked him in the eye, he pointed the gun at her. Rather than panic, she started to talk to him. She was a very kind, gentle woman. She spoke very calmly and very softly, and the young man was drawn to her, and he opened up to her. He told her how he was off his meds, and he was just feeling hopeless. He could see no reason, no point to going on living. Ms. Tough said, "I know how you feel. My husband left me after 33 years of marriage, and last year I tried to commit suicide. By the grace of God, it didn't work." She went on to tell him about how God had given her a new beginning in life, how he had restored her, and about how she had opened up a new business, and now she was excited about the future. She said, "If God did that for me, God could do that for you." So standing there with that assault rifle, students hiding in their classrooms, helicopters circling overhead, that young man put down his gun, and he walked out peacefully. Ms. Tough said afterward, "God put me in that room because I'd been going through the same type of thing that he was going through." Nothing is wasted. The good, the bad, the painful. God knows how to bring blessing out of our broken places. No matter what comes your way, if you keep trusting God, not only will it act like fertilizer in your life and help you, but down the road you'll be instrumental in helping someone else. That's what the Bible says. God comforts us when we are in trouble. Why? God comforts us when we are in trouble so that we can share that comfort with others when they are in trouble. No experience is wasted. Yes, the truth is, with God's help, you can even be the kind of person who can make music out of trash. Yes, you can make music out of your mess. Saw a report about a city in South America that is built on a garbage dump. Trash is everywhere, in the streets, in the river, in their yards. All you can see, as far as you can see in every direction, is waste. Desperately poor people live in that waste without electricity, without plumbing, without clean water. They make their living by going through the trash looking for anything they can sell. Hour after hour, day after day, they rummage through the garbage just to earn a few cents a day. It didn't look like anything good could ever come out of that dark place. But a gentleman named Fabio Chavez came to the city and saw the children playing in the trash, and it just broke his heart. He wanted to help. He decided to start a school of music for the children right there in that trash heap. He didn't have any instruments, so he started looking through the garbage, seeing if he could find any materials he could use. Old pipes became parts of saxophones. Old discarded wooden boxes became the shell of a guitar. Buckets and barrels of all different sizes became drums, all made out of trash. Being a musician himself, Chavez taught the children how to play. They were very excited, and soon they had what they called the recycled orchestra, made up of dozens of children playing instruments that they had made for themselves out of the garbage. One day they put a clip on YouTube, and it went viral. Suddenly they began to receive invitations to play all over the world. Today they fill concert halls everywhere they go, playing before tens of thousands of people. At the end of the segment, the reporter talked with a noted musician who made a statement that kind of stuck with me afterwards. She said, "I couldn't believe you could make music with trash." Well, that's what our God does. He can take all the broken pieces of our lives, the mistakes, the injuries, the injustices, what seems like a waste, what seems like nothing good will ever come from it. And he knows how to make music out of our mess. Other people may not be able to see it, but our God can see it. You may be going through a tough time right now, but God is going to use what you're going through to catapult you forward. Trash can't stop it. People can't stop it. Bad breaks can't stop it. The stuff in life that stinks can't stop it. Even the mistakes that you made and the things that you brought upon yourself don't have to stop it. So let go of what didn't work out and shake off that self-pity. God has new mountains for you to climb. Your best days are not your yesterdays. They are still out in front of you. It may be difficult. It may stink. But remember, it's just fertilizer. It's working for you. You're growing. You're getting stronger. My friend, I know you. You're about to bloom. You're about to blossom. You're about to flourish. In the name of the living God, I speak victory over you. I speak new beginnings. I speak blessings. Health, wholeness, strength, and abundance is yours in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, let's bow our heads and go before our God in prayer. Father, I'm going through something right now, and it stinks. Maybe it's a work situation, a family issue, a health condition, or a relationship with lots of drama. Whatever it is, it's a mess. Father, help me turn my mess into music. And if it stinks, help me smile and say, it's just fertilizer. I need to give it time to work. And never let me forget that no experience is wasted. Like that woman at the well, you can even use my mistakes and my rough past. All that stuff that I thought was working against me, you know how to make it work for me. And one more thing. If you've never invited Jesus into your life, why not do it now? Just say this simple prayer with me. Jesus, sometimes I get in a dark place. I get in a dark mood. But you are the light of the world. Come, brighten up my attitude. I know that you are bright and loving and kind and joyful and positive. So plant your personality and your spirit within me. I trust you, Jesus, as my friend, my mentor, and my Savior. I humbly pray today in your name. Amen. And now we pray together as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, we're going to celebrate the Lord's Supper together today, and you might want to pause this video in just a moment and get some bread or even crackers, some juice or wine. And remember, it's not the presence of the pastor or the priest right there with you in your home or wherever you're watching this. It is the presence of Jesus. That's what makes this powerful. And he is with you right now, no matter where you are, no matter what you're going through. So get ready to welcome him. Well, maybe you're going to a picnic or a cookout this Labor Day weekend. Well, the Bible tells us about a time when a little boy had a picnic lunch with him. And Jesus used it to feed a multitude numbering in the thousands. Now, that little boy's lunch consisted of just five little loaves of bread and a couple of fish. But in the hands of Jesus, it was enough. And no one went away that day hungry. Well, I want to ask you this. What do you hunger for today? It may be physical, it may be financial, it may be emotional, it may be relational. Jesus says to you today, come to me. Come to me and I will fill you up. Long ago, I used bread and fish. Today I'm going to use bread and wine. We remember that on the night when he was betrayed, he took bread and he broke it and he passed it among them saying, take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way also he took the cup, and after giving thanks to his Father in heaven, he passed it among them, saying, take and drink. This is my blood, the blood of the new covenant, which has been poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of all your sins. Do this often in remembrance of me. We invite you now to receive the body and the blood of the living Christ. And now that you have received that body and that blood, may our God keep you strong in the true faith until that magnificent moment when he calls you home. On that day when your time on this earth is complete, you will walk through gates of glory to see your loved ones waiting and to see your God eye to eye and face to face. Amen. Well, you know, people will let you down. People will disappoint you. And human love can fail. But God's love will never fail. Here's our band, recorded live in worship, with Your Love Never Fails.
Joy comes in the morning, and when the strong and the waters deep. I'm not alone here in these open seas, it's your love never fails. The chasm was far too wide, I never thought I'd reach the other side. Your love never
Well, I want to thank you so much for being here today, for joining us for this Sunday morning celebration. And I invite you to join us again next week as we continue to encourage you. And next week, I want to talk about how trouble is transportation. It will never leave you where you find it. You know, we all go through difficulties and we all have things that happen in life that we don't understand. But God uses those things to move us, to transport us toward our destiny. So join us next week for Trouble is Transportation. And our final act of worship today is to receive your tithe and your offering. Go to our website, clcsouthwick.org, and right there on the home page, you'll find that giving tab. And we, and in fact, all the team here at the church, we thank you for your prayers and your love and your support and your consistent giving. We love you and we can feel your love as well. We send you out with this blessing. Now, may the risen Lord Jesus Christ be with you. May he walk ahead of you this week to lead you and guide you. May he walk behind you to strengthen you and support you. And may he walk right beside you every moment of every day as your best and closest friend. Amen. Have a great week, everybody. See you next week.